Hey everybody, it's Stephen and Frederick, and this is How I Cook. Today's episode is chicken wings, crispy chicken wings in the oven. I tried an air fryer. I know people love air fryers for lots of different things, but I really didn't like it for wings. Doesn't hold enough, and I had to move them around to make sure they were all getting crispy and all. So I'm not saying an air fryer is wrong, I'm just saying I prefer this way. Very easy preparation. I got this off of the internet, and I've been using it for quite a while. So what do I have? I have a bunch of chicken wings here. They were frozen. What I like about these are they don't have the tips. I don't have the fuss of cutting them up and having to figure out what to do with the tips. I have done that before, and I've used the tips to make broth. In fact, I just made broth this week. So anyway, you see, I'm taking a dish towel, a clean dish towel, and after they thawed, I rinsed them with water, and now I'm drying them off. So, this is kosher salt. I'm just putting it probably around a teaspoon. In here are 16 pieces of wing. So a tablespoon of kosher salt, and this is baking powder. Not baking soda, baking powder. Very important. This is going to help them crisp. And I'm just going to shake some baking powder on there. That looks like it's between a tablespoon and 2 tablespoons of baking powder. What am I going to do next? Get in there. Mix them up. Get them coated with salt and baking powder. Okay, so I'm back from washing my hands. This is the baking sheet and the cooling rack that we used before when we were making bacon. Same concept. You're going to put the food on the cooling rack. Some of the fat will drop off, and also it allows air to get all the way around it. So we're going to spray some cooking oil. I have the oven preheated at 250 degrees. That's a very low temperature. It's important that you do that first, though. I'll explain why. So I'm just going to lay these out. And we're ready to go in the oven. Just that easy. Chicken wings, baking powder, kosher salt, 250 degree oven for 30 minutes. What's going to happen is it's going to start to cook the chicken. It's going to allow some of the fat to drop off. And then we're going to come back in a half hour, crank up the heat, and finish cooking them. So it's around 5:30 on a Sunday night. This whole prep is going to take around an hour and a half. So what are we going to do? Probably a good time to have a cocktail. I'll be back in a minute with the ingredients for a Manhattan, and I'll show you how I make a Manhattan. All right, see you in a minute. So I'm back, and when I stopped to get the ingredients for the Manhattans, I realized I didn't have my apron on. But I am wearing a t-shirt that I got at our friends Mimi and Martin Myers at their wedding. So a shout out to Mimi and Martin. They got married on May 16th, 2008. So a Manhattan is a cocktail. There are rye Manhattans, bourbon Manhattans. I'm sure people make it with other types of whiskey. We prefer rye. Rye is a grain. Bourbon's fine. I just really like Manhattans. They're not difficult. I'm going to show you how to make it. I'm actually going to measure. I normally don't measure, but for these purposes, I will. Here's a shaker that has a lot of ice in it. And this is bullet rye. It's a good rye, but it's not a really high-end rye. You don't want to use something really high-end that you might want to sip, because you're going to be adding these other ingredients in. So one, this is going to be enough for two Manhattans. It is a Sunday night, and it's going to be an hour and a half making the wings. So two Manhattans in an hour and a half is not bad, considering I have to work tomorrow. So, four shots of rye. This is sweet vermouth. There's also dry vermouth. In a martini, a gin martini, a vodka martini, there's dry vermouth. This is sweet vermouth. This is martini brand. It's a normal, everyday vermouth. Again, nothing too high-end, because you're mixing everything together. So 4-1 is the ratio I like. These are bitters. The classic are Angostura bitters. That's what I'm using this time. There are also flavored bitters that we sometimes use, walnut, chocolate, spiced cherry. But for these purposes, we're just going to use the regular. I like a lot of bitters. That's a lot of bitters. When I order a Manhattan in a bar, I tell the waiter or waitress or bartender, whatever amount of bitters you normally use, just double it. So that, and these are maraschino cherries, not just for kids, not just for ice cream sundaes, just a dash of cherry juice. Next part. Put the lid on tightly, and I'm going to shake it 100 times. These are large ice cubes. Got this ice cube tray at Bed Bath & Beyond. Love it. And I don't always use a cherry in the drink, but I'll put a cherry in there because that's the way they normally serve it. Now, serving the Manhattan over ice is called on the rocks. Serving it up in a martini glass or without ice is called up. I prefer it on the rocks. So there we have it. Another very easy recipe, a Manhattan made with rye. So good. All right. See you back in a few minutes when it's time to crank up the heat on those wings. Okay, so it's been 30 minutes. The wings have been in the oven at 250 degrees. We're going to come over here. Turn the oven up to 425 degrees. We're taking the wings out and we're going to flip them. You can see they are by no means cooked, but the 250 degrees has dried them out a little, and you can't see it, but some of the fat has dropped through the grate. By now, from all my recipes, you know I don't like to tend to food. This is another recipe. It takes a little while, but you don't have to tend to it. So I really like it. All right, the wings have been flipped. The oven is now cranking up to 425. We're going to put the wings in for 50 minutes. My friend Mike Wilson tried this preparation of the wings, and he said it was really good. So, shout out to Mike. We'll see you back in 50 minutes. My drink is a little low. We still have the shaker Manhattan. I told you it was enough for two. All right, see you in 50 minutes. Okay, so it's been around 50 minutes. It's time to take the wings out of the oven. Oh, geez, these look great. Look at those. All nice and brown and crispy. I like to use Hooters wing sauce, the medium. It's hot, or it has a little bit of a kick, but it won't blow your head off. I can't really do too hot. It's like a paste, but as soon as the hot wings hit, it will turn more into a sauce. You do you. Remember, this is how I cook. It's not right. It's not what you should do. It's how I cook. So, let's take the wings off. Great. Okay, now I'm going to toss them in the wing sauce from Hooters. So they're totally coated. There are 16 in here. So I'm going to split them up. 8 per person. And there you have it. Buffalo chicken wings. Wings. This is blue cheese sauce. I know some people prefer ranch sauce. You do you. Whatever you like. If you don't like to dip it in anything, don't dip it in anything. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this episode and have a great week. Take care.